Morning, everybody. Not exactly good morning. We can say good afternoon, everybody. All of you guys, okay? Thank you very much for choosing my videos, my funny and nice videos. And this afternoon, we're gonna start with Chef Gillo, cooking with Gillo. Okay, we're gonna prepare like a Mexican meatballs. Okay, it's one of my favorite foods. It's a Mexican flavor and juicy. And what I can tell you, better than a thousands the foods in this world. Everything we need to prepare like a meatballs, we need to use like the, I don't know exactly about this fry pan. Can be like a 2/4, 3/4, depend the family size, members in your family. So in my family, we are 6 total. It's 4 kids and my wife and I. So I'm gonna try to do like the 15 to 20 meatballs. Okay, one meal is very cheap and very good. So everything you need, what I'm saying before, is like this fry pan with a little bit less than half of water. Bring to the stove. And do you need a rice? Uncooked rice. Because it's the one we're gonna add in the water, okay, in the fry pan. So everything do you need, many people use like something to, how I can say, to measure or to see how much rice you can put them in there. But you not really use any dish or something like that. Just whatever you grab with your hand, with your full hand, not really full, just like this, we're gonna put them in there, okay, in the pan. See how nice, a little bit more. That's it, just a little bit. Because if you put a lot of rice in the fry pan, you're gonna make a, how we can say in Spanish, like a tole, is gonna be too thick, okay? Just be careful with that, don't put too much rice because we're gonna add more rice and the ground beef. So do you need, I have over here like, it's 3 pounds of ground beef, okay? You can buy like a 80, 90% like a, you know, beef is better, not too greasy. I choose like the 73 lean and 27 fat. So it's not too bad, okay? So everything we need, we're gonna open this. I got a knife over here somewhere, right here, okay? Do you need a dish to mix the ground beef with the rice, okay? We got a dish over here. I picked like a glass because it looks so beautiful, okay? So we're gonna open this on the top, right here. Or you can cut in half, either way, you know? Some people cut in half, it's easy, but I open right here, like this, okay? So right there. But I'm not really sure I'm gonna use the whole thing, but let's go save a little bit, like by a quarter of these 3 pounds, okay? So we're gonna mix with a little bit more rice, whatever you grab again one more time with a full hand, like this. Don't put the whole thing. Okay, that's enough, okay? But it's very important for everybody, cook, wash your hands before you do anything. Be sure your hands are very clean, okay? So I got very clean hands. I didn't show in the video, but I got very clean hands. I'm one of those persons, I take care of it very much what I'm doing in the kitchen with the food, okay? Clean hands. Okay, we're gonna move this over. And you got the rice in there, and we're gonna chop like you need 2 tomatoes or 2.5, or you can use 1 tomato or 1.5, it's your choice. It depends how much you like the tomato and to see the red juice in the meatballs, okay? Do you need a garlic clove, or how do you guys call this? Garlic clove, yeah. I should like the big one, see? Almost that much, this size. Like the llama, And do you need like the, this is, you can find in the in the stores, at Walmart. It's like the consomme de pollo. It's in the Mexican aisle. You know, the groceries, Mexican groceries, aisle in Winco and Walmart, you can find it. Let me show you the little bags so you don't confuse. I have a little box right here for sure what you're gonna buy, okay? Right here says caldo de tomate, okay? It's a con sabor a pollo. It's like a tomato juice with chicken flavor, okay? This is like the one of the secrets in the meatball juice, okay? So we're gonna use only one. You can peel it and keep it like this, ready. And everything you need after this, tomatoes, garlic, and this flavor sesame, you know. Do you need oregano? A little bit of oregano. And do you need onion? I'm gonna use a piece of onion. You don't need too much onion, okay? So I got over here all my stuff I need. Oh, except I forgot one more thing. I forgot you need one egg, okay? So the egg we're gonna put over here. See? Beautiful. Okay. We're gonna chop the tomato. We're gonna chop the tomato and the garlic and the onions. We're gonna start with the tomato first, okay? You don't have to chop exactly in little pieces or like the, but don't leave a big pieces either, okay? This one has to be, not supposed to be like a perfect, you know, like, because we're gonna mix with the ground beef to make the meatballs. Wanna put them in like that. I'm gonna do like a tomato and a half. And then we're gonna save one for fry later with the more onion and the garlic. We're gonna fry separately, okay? So. Actually, you know, the last time I cooked this kind of food, I believe it was, maybe it was like a year ago. A year ago, believe it or not. But right now, we're gonna do it again. So you can put the tomato in there. See, right here. We got the tomato in there. We're gonna chop the onion. A little big onion. Onions give to the food always good flavor to the juices, especially to the juices. You don't have to do too much onion in the meatballs. I understand many people not really like onions, but because they don't know what is good. But I know what is good. That's what I put onions in my food. Okay, right there. There you go. See? Nice. Now we're gonna mix it all together, okay?
Pause.
Okay. So mixing a little bit, not too much, and we're gonna add you can use one teaspoon. Yeah, I think one teaspoon, just a little bit, because this, let me show on the camera right here, please. You see, this caldo de pollo is different, like the one I showed you before, like this one. This one has tomato, okay? This one has tomato that is coming in a little squares. But this one right here, the one I got over here, is coming in a this big container, okay? And this is caldo con sabor a pollo. It's like a juice with chicken flavor, okay? This, if you see the color, it's not red. You see, it's not red. Compare this one with the one in the square. You see, it's different. This is red because this one has tomato, but it's the same. And be careful, don't put too much, because this and this, both of them, are salty. This one is salty. If you put too much this or this, you're gonna make a salty meatball juice, okay? So spray all over a little bit like that. We're gonna put just a little bit more, okay? Don't worry about it. So that's what I told you. So right there, that's enough. And keep mixing, okay? Mixing with your hands. Okay, this one looks yummy. Yummy, yummy, yummy. Okay. The reason we put one egg over here is to make like the meatballs like the
a little bit tight, okay? The meat, it doesn't go in the juice like a, we're not gonna make a pieces like that, you know, after it's too boiled, you know, whatever, so it's gonna be a little thick. So that's what is the reason we put the egg. Be sure it's very, very, very mixed, okay? Because the other way, if you didn't mix really right, so the problem is, some meatballs can be salty, and some of it can be not salty. Okay. So when you got already this, if you check right here the water we put with the rice, let me show you the rice, see? It's already boiling a little bit. So you see, this is the rice. You can mix it, shake a little bit and around, slowly, because sometimes the rice can be stuck in the bottom. So, because the water already start boiling, so we're gonna go a low heat. We have in six, and the time to the water is boiling, but when it's boiling already, go to number two, okay? Low heat, and we're gonna start making the meatballs, okay? Okay, you're gonna take this much. It depends the size, do you want the meatballs? You can, many people wants to make a bigger, like that size, but I'm not really like that size. It's better like this size. You can figure it out. See, the meat is very fresh. That's what I like it. You see the color? It's beautiful, nice. And be sure you go in circles around it. Don't leave like any bumps, because you're gonna make a little disaster after you put in the water. You can start putting them in the juice, and the same time you're still making it, put them in there. One, let me see how many we're gonna make in all this much, like a beef we have over here. So remember, it's like that, you can use like a 2 or 3 pounds of ground beef, okay? We got another one right here, two. You need to start putting them in and one by the other one together. Don't throw it only like that, because try to put them in a order to, because like that, in that way, if you can, you can put them in more than what you think in the pan, okay? So, and this beef is pretty good. It's not greasy, it's nice. Okay. The tomato sometimes make like that a little bit complicated. You see right here how I'm doing it? See, tomato right here and tomato right here, it doesn't let the meat to be stuck. So you have to find out and be sure if the bowl is really okay. You can fix it with your fingers right there. I love cook. I like to cook all the time. Because when people learn to cook at home, let me show you, you save $1,000s a year. So you, for real, trust me. In Mexico is one of my cultures. I really like it because over there we don't have any McDonald's. We don't have any Subway. We don't have any Burger King. We don't have any too much fast food. Okay, that means they try to put them in like fast food. But what I can tell you, when you eat too much that, I can call fat food. Fat food. Don't eat too much fast food, because it's gonna make you fat person, okay? With all respect. It's more healthy to eat at home than outside. Many people says, oh, I like to go eat like a tacos, street tacos. Ah, let me show you. You can make a better tacos in your own house than the ones they sell outside. Like a Mexican, let me show you, then I eat many places and many restaurants, or like the, yeah, we can say like a Mexican places, they sell like a Mexican food, and I never compare my food with them food. Okay, my food is more healthy because I know what I like. I'm a very clean person. My food is very clean. And over there, you don't know what they put in your food. Hello? Okay? So be careful when you eat outside. In your own house, So these videos can help a lot to the girls. Teenagers, before you guys marry, you guys need to learn to cook, okay? Not excuse! Go to www.gilloatyourrescuemarriage. Okay? The kitchen. Gillo's kitchen, the cook Gillo, okay? It can save your life, trust me, your marriage. Okay? Because right here, if you marry with a girl not a really cook, hello? When you come home after work, what are you gonna find in the table? Pizza Hut, Domino's. Yeah, Domino's. I don't think so, my friend. I don't think so, okay? It's better this. More cheap, more healthy, more good, and you can eat a lot more. Okay, we almost done with the meatballs. We're still working on, okay? And this actually is very cheap meals. You can, with $10, you can buy a lot of food to cook at your house. Sometimes I cook over here with $5 or $10, and we have for lunch and for dinner, for two meals, okay? So a little by little, you're gonna start watching my videos about my Mexican food. I know later we're gonna make like a chile rellenos, enchiladas, Mexican pastas, Mexican drinks, and Mexican tacos, the ones I show you, and you're gonna love what you're gonna learn. In any case, you try to cook at your house, learning by the video, but if you have any question or any problem with your food, we got a telephone number, emergency telephone number. We can answer your calls, actually, to rescue your meals, okay? So, we're still working on. See, this is one of the hard parts when you put the tomato on it. Many people choose, if you not really want to put the tomato and the beef, you don't have to. You can add it over there in the juice, but we have to fry first tomato, onions, and the garlic, okay? So, because right here is more complicated. You are, and patience grow, or boy, doesn't matter what. So, you can do it either way. But many people, it's what I tell you, it depends, it's your way, it's your choice, so. You don't have to do it my way. You can do it on your way. See? Okay. I know you like my food. And I know with this, I make you hungry. Look at this. Delicious. Ah! This one eating wasn't the video, but I didn't was ready for this smack in the microwave. Anyway, so all these foods, let me tell you, I remember I was little, and I learned all this cook, thanks God for my mother. My mother teach me to cook, and always in my vacations, when I was on vacations at school, I was watching, putting attention how my mother cooked every single meal. And that's what I learned. So when I come to this country in the United States, I put in practice everything I learned from my mother. And look, it's good. Because my lady, my wife, hello, she doesn't cook. This is one of the terrible parts. This is one of my bad dreams in my life. Can you believe that? My wife doesn't cook. I am the cook in the house. But anyway, I love it. And I like it. Because when she cook, oh my goodness, nobody wants to taste her food. If we taste it, in any case, nobody wants to eat it. And guess what? We try to give it to the dog, and the dog come and look at it, what it is, smell it, and he says, I don't want it either, my friends. Poor dog. Can you imagine how terrible my wife cook? Oh my goodness. Okay, we already got everything in the pan. Right there. Okay. You see? It's cooking on a low heat. and good. So I'm gonna show you what else we're gonna do, okay? So your hands are so greasy, have to clean it up. Okay. Okay, the next step, see, we're gonna put one small fry pan. You can put this, you don't need a big fry pan. You can use this size. If you don't have that size, many people use this other size. But you don't need it really, you not really need a big one. We're gonna chop the other tomato we leave over here on the side. And we're gonna add a little big oil. We have the oil over here. Don't put too much oil, just a little bit, okay? Right there. See, not too much, I show you. See, just a little bit, okay? So, and we're gonna chop the tomato with onions and the garlic, okay? Or actually, you can put this one, you can put them in over here. You can smash like this. Okay, this is the caldo de tomate, okay? Don't forget, tomato juice. Okay, right there. Okay, continue with this. Onion. Next is the garlic. You can peel it first. Don't put them in like that, okay? See? Right there, okay? You can do this. Wait, see, we got onions, tomato, and garlic chopped all together. And you got the oil over here in this little fry pan. So we're gonna fry all this together right here, okay? So, okay, we'll see. And you can actually, you can put the a little big oregano. Many people like to measure everything. You can use the same thing like that, this kind of little teaspoon. You can use fresh oregano or like the dry. This is a dry, okay? In Mexico, most of the people, I think the 99% of the people use like a fresh oregano. They have a plant. They like to have a fresh plant like a mint, oregano, and rosemary, dill, and what else? A different kind of doses plants, you know, so. But you can use this one. Don't put too much because oregano flavor is too strong, okay? So don't put too much. Just like that, okay? And now we're gonna put the tomato, onions, and garlic to fry, okay? We're gonna fry for a little bit, okay? So watch. You don't have to wait to heat it up very hot like the oil, no. Because when you put everything in the pan, fry pans, too hot, what you're gonna do is you're gonna, the oil is gonna jump everywhere and it's gonna mix it up a lot more, your stove or your counter or your size, you know, of the stove. But we're gonna mix a little bit. And the time the tomato and the onions and the garlic mix all three flavors. See, I can smell it. It smells like so good. So good. God, I love this kind of smell. Mmm. Can you smell it? Do you smell it? Oh, yes. I know you do. I know you do. See? Like that. Okay. So with the, some people use, we're gonna move a little bit this to see how it's going, everything. Mmm, yummy. It looks beautiful. Look at the color of the juice. See, sometimes when people use like a 70% fat, I mean 30% fat in the ground beef, you can see all the fat over here, but we got the solution. We're gonna let a little bit the meat lose the grease. The grease is gonna come up and we're gonna start taking them out like this. Look, you can see all the fat is coming right here. You see? All this is fat. We're gonna be ready with the little dish. Not this Latino, okay? Like that, look. Look. It's all fat. All that right there. That's what I'm saying. Don't worry about it. For how much fat is the ground beef. You can take it out. It's a lot better. Look at that. We already taken out fat. With that, it's enough. And the time you do that, you see you already got this. Fry a little bit. And you can turn it off in there, this burner. And we're gonna add this in here. Okay, right there. Nice. Beautiful. Don't shake it. Don't just, when you make something, slowly. Right there. Okay? So, and okay, now we're gonna add a little bit more oregano, the one we already lost. See? Right there. Right there. Look at how beautiful. Mmm, it smells good. Now we're gonna give one little taste to see how is an salt, how salty it is. So, to see how is everything, okay? Don't put your mouth in the spoon because you have to put him in a little bit in your hand. Blow it. Put him in like that. Mmm. This one needs a little bit more salt, just a little. But don't put him in more salt yet to when it's completely boiled and the caldo de tomate is already dissolved in there because maybe some pieces is too there, that's why don't put yet more salt, okay? To when it's already completely boiled. And after you put everything together right there, we're gonna leave in a little bit more like the, we're gonna leave this for another 20 to 30 minutes, okay? And a low heat like that, how it is. And you can cover, actually, many people, most of the people like to do that. See, right there, we're gonna cover and we're gonna leave for another 20 or 30 minutes. In 20 or 30 minutes, we're gonna see how everything it is, okay? So, thank you very much. And we come back in a little bit. Okay, welcome back, my people, my audience, okay? So, we have already the meatballs. It's already done. Check it out. It's floating. So it's floating and it's already to eat. But some people like, depend after you taste the meat, if you not really like because it's a little bit hard, you know, it's already cooked and everything. But some people like more soft. You can leave a little bit, for a little bit longer, you know, it depends how you like. But right now, this is a perfect way to eat, okay? Do you guys see one more time how much fat we take it out of the ground beef, you know? So that's not good. And you need one of these mixing bowls. I mean, these bowls, I'm sorry. But, and you need one of these spoons, okay? Deeper spoons. Okay, we're gonna serve a little bit over here. Look at that. Beautiful. One, two, three, okay? I'm gonna add a little bit juice. And the bottom is all the rice. See the rice? Nice. Nice with the rice. Okay, right there. We have a beautiful and good tasty meal. We're gonna taste it. Let me taste how the beef is, okay? You can get your spoon, cut in half a little piece. But very, very careful because it's a little hot. Don't serve right away to the kids, okay? Or yourself, because you can burn it yourself. Mmm, looks yummy to me. And actually smells good. Mmm. 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 Trust me, this is delicious. This is delicious. Some people like to eat with the tortilla. You can warm it up your own tortillas. Eat it with the tortilla. If you not really like tortilla or you don't want to eat with tortilla, you can eat like that. But this is so good. But to eat something else more better for a drink, I choose, guess what? This. Amorello. Morello. This is a good drink. If you sit down together with your wife, don't give me one of these, because ladies in the United States are so aggressive. Very, very careful, okay? You don't want to receive one smack in your face for nothing. Don't give it to drink. Pardon. I'm sorry. To your wife, one of these. Because for ladies, this is more than energy drink. It's aggressive drink. You understand that? Don't give it to your wife. Guess what? But I got good surprise and good solution for giving something to drink to your wife. Give me one of these, and she's gonna be like a sweet, like a kid. For reals, it's true. It's damn true. So don't forget, this is for you, for the men, and this is for the girls, for ladies. Don't do this for ladies and this for men, because remember, that's what ladies control, the men over here. In Mexico, we do, we control, we the boss, okay? Okay, so it's everything, everybody. Thank you very much for enjoying Gigi's Kitchen, Gigi's Cook, okay? Hasta la vista, babies.